Surface charge. Here we consider XYZ plane, and on this XYZ plane we consider an infinite sheet with uniform charge density rho s. So here this is a infinite sheet having a uniform charge distribution. Here the positive charge is uniformly distributed, which having a surface charge density rho s. Now due to this surface charge density rho s, or due to infinite sheet, we have to determine the electric field intensity at point P. This point is situated on z axis. So the coordinate of this point is 0, 0, h, means this point is on z axis, means x and y coordinate is 0, and this point having some height, so this height is h, so the coordinate is 0, 0, h. Now the first step is, on this infinite sheet we consider small differential surface ds and mark with 1. This ds is at some distance rho with respect to origin, and this rho distance having a unit vector e rho. This rho makes some angle phi with respect to x axis. So here we consider a circular cylindrical coordinate system. Now this differential surface ds having a small charge dq, so dq equals to rho s into ds. Now what about ds? So ds value can be calculated using differential length in cylindrical coordinate system. So dl in cylindrical coordinate system is d rho unit vector rho plus rho d phi unit vector phi plus dz unit vector z. Since this infinite sheet is situated at z equals to 0, that is xy plane, so this infinite sheet having a normal direction, that is towards z direction, so differential surface in the direction of z is equals to d rho into rho d phi in the direction of z. So the magnitude part of ds vector is rho d rho into d phi. So in place of ds we can write rho d rho into d phi. Now from here, since ds having a distance of rho, now this point P is at some distance with respect to ds, that is capital R, and this point having some height h. Now we take all the unit vectors, unit vector rho and unit vector R, capital R, that is between ds and point P, and unit vector z towards z axis, that is between point P and origin. So here we using a vector sum method, so rho unit vector rho plus R unit vector R equals to h unit vector z, and here in place of R unit vector R we can write vector capital R. So capital R equals to rho minus unit vector rho plus h unit vector z. The magnitude of this, that is R, is equals to under root rho square plus h square. This unit vector R is equals to vector upon its magnitude. After putting this value of unit vector in equation 1, we get dE, small electric field dE, equals to dq upon 4 pi epsilon naught R vector R upon magnitude cube. So in place of dq we can write rho s into rho d rho into d phi. So after putting this, from the symmetry point of view, for for a symmetrical charge distribution, for every element 1, there is corresponding element 2. So contribution along A row cancel, that is add up to 0. So electric field intensity has only Z component. So due to symmetry, rho component is 0. So the electric field intensity has only Z component. So here there is differential d rho and d phi. So we integrate with respect to rho and with respect to phi. So there is two integration, one for rho and second for phi. Now the rho, the limit of rho, since it is infinite sheet, the limit of rho is 0 to infinity, while the limit for phi is from with respect to x axis, that is from 0 to 2 pi. Now we assume some value, that is let rho square plus s square equals to u square. We consider here this value should is equals to u square for the calculation of this integration. So h is constant, so the derivative differentiation, that is 2 rho d rho equals to 2 u du, and rho d rho equals to u du. So in place of d rho, rho d rho, we can write u du. Similarly, the limits can also be changed. So when rho equals to 0, then u becomes h. When rho equals to infinity, u becomes infinity. So the limits is changed. After putting this, we get a total electric field E. Now we have to calculate this, we have to integrate it, the phi part with respect to phi and u part with respect to u. Now after integration and putting the limits, we get electric field intensity, that is rho s upon 2 epsilon naught unit vector z. Means this electric field intensity has only z component if the charge is in xy plane. This is valid for h is greater than 0, means positive side. For h less than 0, for negative z, unit vector z is replaced by minus unit vector z. Since this is a normal unit vector, so in place of unit vector z, we can write normal unit vector en. So this is a general formula for the infinite sheet, that is electric field intensity E due to an infinite sheet, that is rho s upon 2 epsilon naught unit vector n. And it is independent of the distance between the sheet and point P. Now there is a special case, two parallel sheets. One carries a positive charge and another carries a negative charge. So the surface charge density for positive is rho s and surface charge density for negative is minus rho s. So due to this, it makes a parallel plate capacitor, and the electric field is generated from positive charge and terminate to negative charge. So accordingly, the electric field intensity due to this parallel plate capacitor becomes rho s upon epsilon naught unit vector n. Here we consider a two sheet, so the formula is same, but the direction, normal direction is opposite. So the electric field intensity due to parallel plate capacitor is rho s upon epsilon naught unit vector n. Now consider a numerical portion. The question is, find the force on point charge q, small q, located at 00 h meter due to charge on surface charge density rho s, unit is coulomb per meter square, uniformly distributed over a circular disk, rho less than or equals to a, and z equals to 0 meter. So according to this question, there is a circular disk having radius a, and that is situated on z equals to 0 meter, that is on xy plane. So there is a circular disk situated on xy plane, and we have to find the force on point charge small q that is located at 0, 0 h, that is on z axis. Okay, now the circular disk having a surface charge density rho s. So this is a similar type question. Now first step is we have to consider a differential surface ds at some distance rho. This rho makes some angle phi with respect to x axis. Now this ds having a small charge dq, that dq equals to rho s into ds. Now since ds, now this surface having a normal direction, that is towards z axis, so the differential surface ds in the direction of z can be determined from the differential length, that is rho d rho into d phi in the direction of z, and the magnitude part is of ds is ds equals to rho d rho into d phi. So in place of ds we can write rho d rho into d phi. Now this ds having a distance rho with respect to origin, and this rho having a unit vector a rho. Again this ds is having a distance r with respect to point p. So here we consider a vector r having a unit vector ar, and this point having a height h, and its direction is towards z axis, so here we consider a unit vector z. Now using a vector sum, so rho unit vector rho plus vector r capital R equals to h unit vector z. So the vector r equals to rho minus a rho plus h unit vector z. So unit vector r capital R equals to vector upon its magnitude. So we use a force formula, Coulomb force. Due to this ds, there is a small charge dq, and accordingly a Coulomb force, both are positive, so it is ripple force. So the small force df equals to small q into dq upon 4 pi epsilon naught r square in the direction of r. So after putting these values, the value of dq, the value of r, we get this. And in place of unit vector r, we can write vector upon its magnitude. Since due to symmetry, the rho component is cancel out. For every element, there is an opposite element which cancel, whose effect is cancelled with each other. So there is only z component here. Now similarly there are two differential terms, d rho and d phi. So there is two integration, one integration with respect to rho and second integration with respect to phi. The limit of rho equals to 0 to a, that is radius, and the limit of phi is from 0 to 2 pi. So here we assume that rho square plus s square equals to u square to calculate this integration. So 2 rho d rho equals to 2 u du, 2 d is cancelled, rho d rho equals to u du, and the limit is also changed. When rho equals to 0, u equals to h, and when rho equals to a, u equals to under root h square plus a square. After putting these values, and we simply calculate this integration and putting the limits, we get a force F, total force, that is Q upon rho S upon 2 epsilon naught whole bracket 1 minus H upon under root H square plus E square in the direction of z. So here we find a force on point charge q. Also, we can also calculate the electric field intensity at this point P, that is force per unit charge. So it simply becomes rho s upon 2 epsilon naught whole bracket 1 minus h upon h square plus e square whole to power 1 by 2, that is under root, in the direction of z. Now there is a case for infinite sheet. For infinite sheet, a small a tends to infinity. So here when you put a equals to infinity, we get rho s upon 2 epsilon naught in the direction of z, or in the direction of z, unit vector z can be written as normal vector. So this is a similar formula as we seen in infinite sheet. So this is a surface charge distribution problem, and this is a electric field intensity formula when the sheet is circular disk having a finite radius a, and when this radius is infinite, that is infinite sheet, we get a E, electric field intensity equals to rho s upon 2 epsilon naught. So we have to remember this formula. Okay.